Hey guys, it is review time, and this one is for Sean Baker's latest, The Florida Project. The movie centers on a six-year-old girl named Mooney who lives with her mother in a Florida motel that's located right near Disney World that happens to be called the Magic Castle. Mooney's got minimal supervision, so she basically spends her days running from motel to motel in the area with her friends, playing, and getting into a good deal of trouble along the way. This is an incredibly immersive movie, and Baker captures it all beautifully and mostly from Mooney's perspective. May not be a traditional childhood, and some certainly might not approve of how Mooney's being raised, but Baker depicts her day-to-day life in a way that lets you feel her joy and excitement for everything from making a new friend to getting a free ice cream. But then we also get some heartbreaking situations and realities, and there are moments that wind up being even more upsetting because Baker presents most of it as Mooney processes it. You're essentially a fly on the wall in that it's easy to see Mooney's mother is barely getting by and taking them down a pretty dangerous path, but then there's also the charm of being in the mind of a playful, imaginative six-year-old, and the two pair together in a way that makes the Florida Project a really rich and poignant experience. On the performance front, I am betting you're gonna hear more about Brooklyn Prince after this. To give such a raw, powerful, and natural performance at such a young age is just astounding to me. I'm also eager to see more of Bria Venete after this, who plays Mooney's mother. I was shocked to learn that she was discovered on Instagram because she really delivers an incredible performance in this, capturing both genuine, palpable love for her daughter, but then also a highly destructive, explosive, and childish attitude. And it's a frustrating thing to watch, really, wishing she could pull it together for the two of them, but also fully understanding her circumstances and what holds her back from doing that. And then, of course, there's Willem Dafoe as Bobby, the manager of the motel, and I think this might be one of my favorite performances of his, really ever, maybe. The Florida Project is mostly Mooney's story, but Dafoe, Baker, and his co-writer on the movie, Chris Burgosh, do such a fantastic job weaving Bobby into the narrative that makes him feel like a fully realized person and character, which is especially impressive because it's not done through character backstory. The viewer basically gets to know Bobby here through his relationships with the renters, how he deals with certain problems, and also just watching him walk around and fix things around the motel. Even when Dafoe isn't on screen, you still have this feeling that Bobby is watching over the place, and then when he does get involved, it's kind of a delight to watch Bobby process situations and then take action, especially as someone who willingly takes responsibility for certain renters. The Florida Project really is just more exceptional work from Baker. If you haven't seen his last film, Tangerine, you really should check that out, but I am also highly recommending Florida Project big time because I'm giving it 4.5 Deweys out of 5 on the Dewey Decimovie scale. It is one thing to tell a compelling story, but when you can so wholly envelop a viewer in a landscape and offer up so much access to your characters like Baker does here, it's a truly special level of investment and emotion. If you've seen The Florida Project yourself, I want to know what you think. Do you feel as strongly about it as I do? Hit that comment section below. And before I close out this review, it is time to circle back around and give Scuba Steve another Patreon shout out. Scuba Steve's been with the campaign since day one, and I am so thankful for his dedication. Thanks to everyone out there watching this video right now. Please like, share, and subscribe, and I will see you real soon with more movie reviews.